What's up everyone, it's your boy MSRacing42 aka Nathan Zapnia, and welcome everyone to Talladega Super Speedway for race number 13 on the season for season 2 of the NIOA M&M's Truck Series. We are here today for the final Super Speedway race on the season and for the finale of the round of 8. It's Pally 250 at Talladega. It's been an interesting round, to say the least, to follow in the round of 8 versus Chicagoland Speedway, and we saw absolute chaos. Last time out at Rockland Flynn, we saw absolute chaos, and now we are here at Talladega, and we will probably see even more absolute chaos. It's going to be 25 laps of that here today at Talladega, and it's going to be wild, 3 and 4 wide racing, and who knows, the big one can strike and take out multiple of these championship contenders. So coming into this race, you guys have the championship playoff standings look coming into this race. Christian Russell, he's already locked in. He's 54 points above the cutoff line. For Derek Hamill and Matthew Paul, they are almost locked in. All they have to do is not finish last, and they will be good to go to make it. Eli Bright, he's plus 33. He's almost a lot to make in as well. So it's really four drivers going for two spots in the round of 6. But Seela is plus 19, and Riley Spurgeon is plus 17. And then below the cutoff line, Benny Watson is minus 17, and Evan Hunter is minus 23. So for Watson and Hunter, they have to just survive and get top 10, and hope that Brett Seeler and Marley Spurley too. And I'm end up being involved in one of the big ones and fall deep in the field. So it's going to be a long shot, but it's not that big of a long shot here today at Talladega Super Speedway. Earlier today, an hour ago, we saw the qualifying heat race to see if what six part-time trucks would make it into the Powerway 250, and the six trucks were Eric Marco, Owen Miles, Bradley Lean, Trey Smith, Alex Bonsignor, and number 7 of Jacob Dillons. So, with that being said, let's go ahead and get the engines fired for race number 13 on the season, and for the final race of the round of 8, and for the Powerway 250 at Talladega. And all 36 truckers will get rolling off for the Powerway 250 and for the final Super Speedway race of the season. The season started at Daytona, and we saw the number 20 of Riley Spurley to get the job done. Will he be able to get the win here today and lock himself in to the round of 6? Will it be one of the other playoff contenders? Will it be a non-playoff contender, or will it be a part-time truck? We've seen no playoff drivers win yet in this round and in the playoffs. The only way that Christian Russell is locked in is because he got enough points to lock himself in. So, it will be 25 laps of action here today at Talladega Super Speedway. And no pit stops, since it is a Super Speedway. And it's going to be a wild, wild race. Have to watch out for the big one to strike. When will it happen? No one knows, but it is bound to happen. And it is bound to take out a lot of drivers at Talladega. So, it will be Jake Gilmerson and Brett Sealer in second. Dale Campbell third. Matt Monaco in fourth. Owen Miles fifth. Zach Rigolo in sixth. Stephen Collins in seventh. Mitchell Collins in eighth. And then it's Henry Williams and Eli Bright. Here we go. The Powerade 250. Chase race number 3 and race number 13 of the season is green at Talladega Super Speedway. Dale Campbell will lead lap number 1, and as we saw in the trial, they already went 4 wide, but they will keep it straight, and they settle it back down. That's the big thing about Talladega, just like Daytona, 4 wide does not work that well. Dale Campbell out front, but here comes DJ Reed from help from Daytona winner Riley Spurley to the inside of Dale Campbell. Playoff contenders 2, 3, 4 right now here at Talladega. And Benny Ross, one of those drivers that need to have a good one here today if he wants to continue his shot at gold in the MM Cup Series. Riley Spurley to try to get his second win on the season, to get his second win on a super speedway, and then 2 out of the 3. Josh Williamson going to help Benny Watson in the number 3, but Luke Lee, massive one. He's going to take advantage and go to the inside of Williamson. Roy Hagen, now up to the 3rd, and he's going to look with Lily. Lily Hagen's going to work with Luke Lane, and Lane is going to go to the race lead at Talladega, but just like that, Hagen is going to back out. And as you saw, they were 4 wide back there for a second, but they still are, but they're going to sell it back down now. Nathan Fan in the number 4 going to the race lead, and here comes the 83 of Evan Hunter, another truck that needs to have a good one here today at Talladega. 23 points back. He needs a top 10, and he needs his other two contenders to have bad ones here today at Talladega. And this is step number 1. Trying to take the race lead and leading the lap and get a bonus point, but he's not going to be able to, at least for now. Dale Lightning, who won at Watkins Glen, trying to go 2 in a row, takes the race lead. Here comes Trey Smith in the number 17, looking to the inside of Dale Lightning for help from Roger Way and Jacob Dillons. So far, so good. 5 laps complete at the line this time by. But that's only 1/5 of the way through. 20% out of 100% complete. 20 laps to go still. A long way to go in the Powerade 250. Matthew Call going to the race lead now. She's trying to win her 3rd win on the season. Here comes Shane Winsloff and here comes his fellow forward, Christian Russell, as well. But he's going to try to develop Mason Cole on the outside lane. And they are four wide in the middle of the pack. But they are going to keep it straight for now, it looks like. And no, they won't. They're going to save it for now. Well, no, they won't. Maybe, I don't know. Oh, Eli Bright, but Sela. And they're going to save it. Oh, Juan Garcia. Juan Garcia was not able to save it. He hit the outside wall, spun around. Luckily, no one hit him. And we stay green somehow. Here at Talladega. But that just split up the pack big time. And now for Eli Bright, Brett Sela. They are in the second pack. And they have to try to catch up with the sleep pack. But they might not want to, though. They're all the way back to four wide in the sleep pack, two rows deep. We might see the big one here very, very soon. Four wide, two rows deep at Talladega. That's almost five wide. That's almost four wide, three rows deep. That's four rows deep. Four wide, four rows deep. And there they go, wrecking behind them. In the second pack, nowhere to go. They're going to save it. They'll never mind. Eli Bright, Riley's Bully Tube, Emily Anderson. But not to make big hits though, but it looks like Eli Bright, Bully Tube's going to try to help Eli Bright not get stuck on the apron. Eli Bright gets saved, but Bully Tube's going to be stuck on the apron. And that might have just cost his Bully Tube a shot at the championship. DJ Reed on pit road, and Marley's Bully too. Not that big of a crash, but it was big enough to cause some drama. Eli Bright, Emily Anderson, Trey Smith, and a couple of us involved as well. Make sure that everyone slows down and gets themselves in the right positions here. It looks like everyone will, and we will have no issues here under the caution flag. So with that being said, I have a little bit of contact back there, but it should be fine. So with that being said, since there's no pit stops, let's go ahead and see what happened to bring out the first caution of the day here in the Poway 250 in season number 2 of the NIRA M&M's Truck Series. Here we go, this is what happened. They were 4 wide, 4 rows deep. I'm surprised that they didn't crash up ahead, but they ended up crashing for the last spot in this pack. Larry Hagan and DJ Reed got together and a bit up the track and into Trey Smith, Larry Hagan's teammate. And then DJ Reed into the outside wall. Larry Hagan saves it. So does Trey Smith, but then half into the side of the 54. And then Eli Bright gets involved, but they save it. And then back down into Emily Anderson and then into Riley's Bully Tube. Al Sponsor got a piece of it, but Sela nearly got involved, but he got unscathed. Looks like the 97 got a little tap. Yeah, just not a little bit. But everyone else is okay. And Bully Tube and DJ Reed, that's what happened to them. They were going to be fine. Just a little bit of damage. But they ended up being stuck on the apron. Bully Tube then decided to push Eli Bright off of the apron and save his potential championship hopes, but at the same time, that might have just ruined his championship hopes here at Talladega. Final round of the 54 of Larry Hagan. on board the Vanilla Toy of Wily's Trolley Team. And since we are on the caution, we will take a look at what happened that should have brought out a caution but didn't. Eli Bright and Jonathan Ross fought together, they saved it, and then Roger Hampton and Ron Garcia made contact multiple times. Garcia saved it again in the grass, but then lost control. Owen Miles saved it, and then Garcia tried to gain payback on Roger Hampton, but Roger Hampton just turned Ron Garcia into the outside wall. That didn't look like a big hit, but unfortunately, that ended up taking Ron Garcia out of the race here in the Power 250. The defending 12 Series champion has just had one rough season in Season 2 of the M&M's 12 Series, and this just continues its bad luck this season. Welcome back here at Talladega Super Speedway. We will go back wing. Why about halfway through the Power 250 on that number 13? The only truck that is out is Juan Garcia. We still have 35 trucks on the track. DJ Reed and Molly's Bully Tube are back on track, but on one lap down, that might have just ended Bully Tube's championship hopes. But who knows, we might not be done crashing yet here at Talladega. That's for sure. Back wing on lap number 13, Wally's Spurly Tube's teammate, Zach Guerrero, will lead us back to the wing here at Talladega. Spurly Tube gets a great one on the outside lane, and he will fall right in front of DJ Reed. Now this is going to be the ultimate test. With that slight amount of damage, how slow is DJ Reed and Wily's Bully Tube, and will they cause a factor in this race? Josh Williamson trying to get a one on the outside and get by to catch up with the old tooth of Zach Guerrero, but he can't get by him. He had no help. Now he has help, but now both twists are blocking the outside lane. But both lap trucks are blocking both lanes, but obviously that inside lane is going to be the place to be still. And Jacob Dillon shoves Wily's Bully Tube right out of the way, and Jacob Dillon with a massive one from help from Stephen Collin is going to go to the race lead here at Talladega. Mitchell Collins is going to make it 3 wide for second. Dale Lightning is coming up here as well. And Eli Bright, that's not good at all. He is losing the draft. But he might also be hoping and playing for for some more damaged cars and more cars to get out. But right now, it is Ford on the bottom. Never mind. Winslow going to go to the race lead. Winslow has help from Christian Russell. He's already locked in, so he can go for broke and try to win this race here at Talladega. He doesn't care. It won't matter. That's almost 4 wide. That is 4 wide already. Boston Roar on that number 11 makes it 4 wide. They're going to sell it back down though. Looks like Spurley Tube and yes, Bully Tube and but yeah, it looks like Bully Tube and DJ Reed, they're not too slow off the pace, so they should be fine. But for Charvin Hoff, Trey Smith, and then for Roger Hampton and Eli Bright, they are too much off the pace and they are too slow. 10 laps to go, Alex Bonsignor out front, Bradley Ream in second, Fail Camel in third. We technically haven't seen the big one strike yet, but when will it strike? Who knows? Alex Bonsignor in the number 46 for KBM leads Eli Talladega with 9 laps to go. Dale Campbell in second, and Zach Winkle in third, and Brett Steele fourth car on the inside lane, currently in fifth. Dale Campbell with a slingshot move is going to try to get the one and get by for the race lead. I thought I heard it spin, but I guess I didn't. Remember, under 5 laps to go, the race will be official though. So if they want to crash, it has to be before lap 16. Or before lap 21. So they have 3 more laps before they crash and it will be official. Dale Campbell off one. Here comes Evan Hunter out of nowhere in the 83 truck, up to 2nd. But the post is Jake Emerson with a massive one. And Emerson has help from two GMS Racing teammates, Keegan Thompson and Madison Tall. That's almost 4 wide deep in the field. They're going to settle it back down. Things are starting to intensify. Here at Talladega. 7 laps to go in the power lane, 250. Madison Tall not going to go for the race lead. She's pretty much locked in now because of Juan Garcia being out and with 212 being stuck a lap down, so she can go for broken out. And that's exactly what she's doing. She's going to go to the race lead. And how about Larry Hagan? He was involved in that crash, but he was mostly spun. Now he's back up here in second. Where did PJ Williams come from? Now he's up to second now. That's 4 wide deep in the field. Will they sell it back down? Yes, they will. PJ Williams out front, 6 laps to go at Talladega. Jake Emerson back up front. DJ Reed, he's 1 lap down, but he's up front. Do you want to get his lap back if we get a caution this lap? But it does not look like we will. Jake Emerson is going to have a pretty good gap on the field. But I don't know if you want to have that big of a gap though. Here we go, 5 laps to go, 5 laps to go in the Power 250. You're at Talladega. The green on the inside of Jake Emerson is going to take the race lead away. But here comes Cody Smollett and Nathan Bears. Coming out of nowhere as well. Nathan Bear's gonna make it 3 wide for the race lead. Here comes Bully Chip and here comes Brett Sealer and Benny Watson as well. They're making the way up front. And how about Josh Williamson and that 6 foot also making his way up front. Benny Watson in the number 3. He will take the race lead away with 4 laps to go at Talladega. These guys have been pretty calm all race long up to this point, but when will they turn it up a notch? And oh, Josh Williamson blows up! Josh Williamson blows up in the number 6 truck. And he's gonna block all He's gonna block a bunch of the field. Dale Campbell, Stephen Collin, Nathan Fain, Zach Winkle, Bradley Ream, a handful of others. And that might have just costed some of these guys their championship hopes in the Eminem Sports Series. Back up front is Zachary Gallo up front, three laps, go at Talladega. Nathan Bailey in second, Jacob Jones in third, Brett Seale in fourth. Benny Watson in fifth, Christian Russell in sixth, Cody Smoke in seventh. And then it's Luke Green in eighth, Jake Gimmison in ninth, and PJ Williams in tenth. But I think it's going to be about a 7-12 battle for this race win now, with two laps to go at the line. That's the template for Josh Williamson, but we might be in for one heck of a finish. Penny Watson in the number three. Up front. One and a half, coming to the white flag net standby. He needs this. He needs to have a good finish. And it's looking like he's going to get it. He might even win this race. Coming to the white flag at the line. Three playoff contenders are in the wall on the inside lane. Watson, Russell, and Seale. I think Cody Smoke might be able to get it, though. We have to wait and see. Ben Watson is going to get... Ben Watson to the top side. I cannot speak. White flag final up here at Talladega for the Powerway 250. But Seale in second, Cody Smoke in third, Jacob Jones in fourth. But Seale might have a pretty good shot at it. The Brett Seale or Cody Smoke. I don't know. Now I think it's going to come down to Brett Seale or Christian Russell. A little bit of lag there. I don't know what that was all about. But coming off of turn 3 and 4. Brett Seale going to get a massive one, but Cody Smoke's going to stop it. Brett Seale's going to get second. He's going to start second and finish second. But Christian Russell will win the Powerway 250. He was already locked in, and now he gets the win. And that's going to be 5 extra bonus points going into the round of 6 for Christian Russell. Wow. Brett Seale in second, Cody Smoke third, Benny Watson in fourth. That might be enough to make his way into the round of 6. Jacob Jones in fifth, Nathan Bailey in sixth, Zachary Dolello in seventh, Jake Emerson in eighth, PJ Williams in ninth, and Luke Wayne in tenth. Only one caution here today at Talladega. That is very, very odd. But to be honest, if Josh Williamson did not blow up, we would have crashed under 5 laps to go. We would have. They were getting really antsy late in the going, and we would have had one heck of a finish here at Talladega. So, here is the finishing results for the Powerway 250 in Season 2. Of the Eminem Strut Series. Christian Russell gets the win, Brett Seale in second, Cody Smoke third, Benny Watson fourth, Jacob Jones fifth, Nathan Baird sixth, Zachary Dolello in seventh, Jake Gimson in eighth, PJ Williams ninth, and Luke Wing in tenth, Monaco in 11th, Colin Henderson, Lightning Collins, Ream, Winslow, Winkle, Williams, and Hunter round out the top 20. And then the rest of the results, 32-12 finish on the lead lap. Riley Spillitude was 1 lap down. DJ Reed was 2 laps down. And the cause of the blow up was for Josh Williamson blowing up a camshaft. So at top 8 for Wolves, Josh Benson, and then number 6 12 for Norm Benning Racing, and then Juan Garcia, the only 12 out with crash damage here at Talladega. A pretty interesting race here at Talladega, but it did not disappoint at all. Lots of drama, and who knows, a couple trucks might just see, well, it is confirmed two trucks will see their championship hope. The championship dreams come to an end, but we don't know who those two trucks will be. Thank you guys so much for watching here at Talladega Super Speedway for race number 13 of the season and for the Power 225, the Power 250. Next time out it will be the Ford Eco Boost 200 at Michigan International Speedway. That's gonna be one heck of a race. Slide drop city, 2-3, sometimes 4 wide, and to those maybe even 5 wide. It's gonna be one heck of a race at Michigan to kick off the round of 6. So until next time, just start the round of 6 at Michigan for the Ford EcoBoost 200. Coming up next is the regular season points, the playoff standings, looking at the year points, and pronounce here at Talladega Super Speedway. Until next time, for race number 14, as we kick off the round of 6 for the Ford EcoBoost 300, I will see you guys in the Irish Hills of Michigan. Once again, congrats to Chris Russell on getting the race win. And until next time at Michigan, I will see you guys later. Bye!